Hi everyone. Well, it's 100 degrees right now and it's going to be even hotter this weekend. And if you don't protect your plants during the heat, they're going to burn. So in today's episode, we're going to talk about four ways you can protect your garden during a heat wave. Now, these four tips are very quick, simple, and inexpensive. And if you can implement them now before the heat hits, you'll be one up on the game. But if not, and the heat is already upon us, then better late than never. Once the temperature hits 90 degrees Fahrenheit, the plants get very stressed out. You're going to notice a couple of things. On your tomatoes and peppers and cucumbers and maybe even your squash, you're going to notice the blossoms start to dry up and possibly fall off. You'll also notice fruit production slow down because the plants get very stressed when they're that hot. And all their energy is going into just staying alive, not to interproducing fruit. So we want to minimize the stress on the plants as much as we can by implementing some stress reduction measures for our garden. The first tip to reducing the heat stress on your plants is to harvest any fruit or vegetables that might be ripening, because it takes a lot of energy for the plant to keep the fruit or the vegetable on the vine. So by harvesting them, you're allowing all of the plant's energy to go into protecting itself from the heat. So here we have a couple of beautiful tomatoes that are just starting to turn. In fact, these are my very first full-size tomatoes of the season. This is the Arkansas Traveler tomato, which is in my spring garden seed collection. It's actually a very heat-tolerant tomato, so it should do just fine in the heat. But would you look at that tomato? This is the first full-size tomato of the season here, guys. So it's pretty exciting. It's not quite all the way red, but because of our high temperatures, I'm gonna harvest it and let it finish up ripening on the countertop. So I've got one more down in here that I am going to harvest, and a bunch of green ones, which I'll leave on the vine, but this is pretty exciting. Even during a heat wave, the garden is still giving. Wow, those are beautiful tomatoes. Now I have a couple on a plant right next to me. These are the Siberian tomato. And this plant is actually a more cold tolerant tomato. But you can see that just the first blush here. So I'm gonna go ahead and just take a couple of these off. And these will ripen up just fine on the countertop or in a brown paper bag. Second tip is increase the frequency of watering to really help reduce the stress on your plants so they don't dry out and have the water they need to make it through the heat. Now I have my garden here hooked up to drip irrigation, but I just bumped it up from 30 minutes every 3 days to 45 minutes every 3 days. So the water really gets down into the roots where the plants need it the most. But what I'm gonna do is come out tomorrow during the heat of the day and check the soil to see how it's doing. So you always want to keep an eye on your plants and be checking them during a heat wave. So I'm just going to put my finger down here into the soil. And if it feels dry, it means my plants need a little bit more water. So I'll turn on my drip irrigation again and give them a little 10-minute drink. Now, if you're not using drip irrigation, you're watering with a hose, super easy, guys. You just want to make sure you water your plants deeply. Now, I do like to water my plants first thing in the morning so the plants have the water they need to make it through the heat of the day. So with a nozzle, you're just going to water your plants so there's a little puddle around the base, and then let it soak in. And once it soaks in, you're gonna water it again so the water gets all the way down to the roots of the plants where it needs it the most. And you're gonna do the same principle where you're gonna come out and check your plants. Just put your finger in the soil. If it feels wet, your plants are good. If it's dry, you need to water. So definitely check your plants daily during a heat wave to see if they are getting the moisture that they need. Now, container plants are a whole different animal. They'll definitely need checked once a day, maybe twice a day during those high temperatures. So I'm definitely gonna be switching my irrigation here to water once a day, and then come out here and the same thing. I'm gonna check my plants. See, these are a little bit dry. And sometimes containers might need watering even twice a day during a heat wave. So you don't wanna let your container plants dry out even once, because that will really stress them out and they're not gonna grow near as well. So I'm just gonna soak down the soil really, really well. So that way the plants aren't stressed out and have the water they need to make it through the heat. I'm gonna water this container until the water runs out the bottom. So the water's draining out the bottom now, and this plant is getting a good drink that it needs to make it through the heat. Remember, the first tip is harvest any vegetables that are almost ready to harvest. Second tip, make sure you're watering more frequently. And the third tip, you guys have any guesses? I'll give you a little hint. What do I always say to do to your garden beds after you plant it? Well, if you guessed mulch, you're correct. So the third tip is to mulch your garden beds. And the reason for this is it really helps with water evaporation. It provides a barrier to the soil from the sun so that the soil stays moist longer, and it really helps reduce the stress on your plants. So I just dug up this garden bed last week. I planted a couple of squash seeds in here. So I'm gonna mulch the area where I have the seeds very, very lightly so the seeds can still come up. But this is shredded, these are shredded leaves. Now, if you don't have shredded leaves, you can use straw, you can use dried up grass clippings, whatever you can find to cover your soil so you don't have any bare soil will really, really help with the water evaporation and help protect your plants against the heat and help them get less stressed out. So I'm gonna put an inch or so of mulch over this garden bed and it will be good to go. Smells so earthy too. Okay, there we go. Our plants are nice and insulated, and that will really help them stay cool during the heat wave. So we've got our harvest, we've got our watering, we've got our mulching. The last tip is shading. Shading helps reduce the stress of your plants so much during a heat wave because it just provides a little bit of cover for your plants so they can survive during the hot temperatures. Now, a couple different options you can use for shade cloth. Look around your house and see if you have anything around your house you can use. I happen to find this old sheer curtain, and this is actually a really good shade cloth because it still allows some of the sun's rays to go through. Now, if you don't have a sheer curtain, another thing you can use is an old sheet or a curtain that is not sheer like this one is. And although this won't allow the sun's rays to go through, it's still good to use in a pinch because it'll definitely protect your plants from the sun. Now, what I'm going to use today to cover this whole entire area right here is a piece of shade cloth I picked up on Amazon. Now, this has holes in it. So it's a 40% block, which means it will block out 40% of the sun's rays. It's a perfect thing to use to cover this whole area because my plants will still get some sun, but it won't be quite as intense. So let's get this cover here. Now, don't tell Gary, but here's a little peek at the beefsteak tomato. Remember, we're having that beefsteak tomato challenge. The way off is gonna be in a month or so. So I'll give you guys a little peek here. I'll be doing an update video on that soon, but I definitely want to protect this tomato during the heat wave. Because see these little flowers on here? I don't want these flowers dropping off in the heat wave because this is where my giant beefsteak tomato is gonna grow. Now, you don't need anything fancy to put your shade cloth up. I am just going to pound a pole in the garden bed right up here so that the corner of my shade cloth has something to clip onto. So this is just a pole I had laying around my garden, and gonna pound it in. It's pretty tall, so I'm gonna have to get up here. Need a camera guy to come up here and do this for me. Pole pounded in, and I'm just gonna keep it simple and just drape my shade cloth over my giant tomato cage here. Remember when I put that big, huge tomato cage up for the beefsteak tomato? So it's pretty tall. I'm gonna have to climb up here. And the sun hits this way in the afternoon, so I'm gonna drape it as far over on this side as I can so it gets shade in the late afternoon. I think I might need a ladder here. Always fun in the garden, huh? Now I'm gonna clip this shade cloth down low here because it's a squash plant I have underneath, and that way it'll protect the squash plant from the heat. If it was a taller plant, I would clip it up higher. Clip it over here to the tomato cage. try and get as much drapage over the cage as I can to really help protect it from the sun. And I want to clip it on so it doesn't blow around in the wind. And now let's head back down to the beefsteak tomato cage to make sure that one is well protected. I'm going to add a few more clips in here. There we go. That shouldn't blow away. And I'll stretch out over here to protect my pepper plant. And I may have to add a little few extra pieces here so this whole garden bed is protected. Now I am going to add some extra pieces here on my beefsteak tomato because I want to make sure that this plant is good and protected from the sun, both the afternoon sun and the morning sun. So I've got an extra piece here that I'm going to attach to this cage so it's completely surrounded by shade cloth. And hopefully that'll really help reduce the stress on this plant and those blossoms won't drop off during the heat wave. So you just make it work with whatever you have to work with. Wow, that looks great. So I ran out of my clips, so I'm just using an office clip. I mean, use whatever you have to make it work for you. Well, I may not be able to shade my entire garden to protect it from the heat wave, but at least I have some of my special plants shaded. Now, what I'm also gonna do is pop up the umbrellas around the garden and shade whatever I can. Now, I'm also gonna use my old curtains here to shade my strawberry crate towers because strawberries don't do well when it gets over 85 degrees. So this will still allow a little bit of the sun to get through, and keeping them well watered and mulched will help them make it through the heat wave. By using these four tips, by harvesting your fruits and vegetables, by watering more frequently, mulching to help prevent evaporation, and by using shade cloth in your garden, you can help protect your garden during a heat wave so your plants don't burn up. Well, comment below, let me know how hot it is in your garden and what you're doing to protect your garden from the heat. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you in the next video.